Doesn't it bother you that the referee uses Japanese during a match? We'll find out the meaning of every single phrase that he or she uses in this video. Aka. 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 Aka means red in Japanese. Ao. 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 Ao means blue in Japanese. Some organization might have aka and shiro, so shiro also means white. Seiretsu. 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 Seiretsu means line up. So maybe before a kata competition starts, you might line up in two lines or in one line. And some referees might say seiretsu to let you guys know that it's time to line up. Shomen ni rei. Shomen ni rei. Shomen ni rei. Shomen ni rei. Shomen ni means to the front, and rei means to bow. So before any kind of game, kumite or kata, you line up and then you do a bow to the front, and the referee would say shomen ni with this hand sign, rei, and then you would bow down. Otagai ni rei. Otagai ni rei. Otagai ni rei. Otagai ni rei. Otagai ni means to each other, and rei means bow. So after doing shomen ni rei, which is bow to the front, then you turn to each other and then you bow. So that's otagai ni rei. Hante. 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 Hante means judgment. So that's the point after the kata, when both of you perform and you guys come to the center again and the referee says hante, and then with the whistle they raise the flag up to tell you who wins. So that's hante. Senshu. 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 Senshu means players. So before starting kumite game, you would line up outside the court and the referee would say senshu, and then you guys would bow to each other. So it means player, but it's also a notification to let you guys know that it's time to bow at each other before entering the court. Shoubu hajimete. Shoubu hajimete. Shoubu hajimete. Shoubu hajimete. Shoubu means a competition or a game, and hajime means to start. So before the kumite starts, the referee will stand in the center and say shoubu hajimete to let you guys know that it's time to start. If I say the details, shoubu hajime with the me sound is timing when the competition starts. So it's not, so you start moving after you hear me, not during shoubu and you move. So make sure you listen until the end and then you move. Yame. 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 Yame means to stop or to quit. So it's used in kumite when someone lands a point or someone hits someone too hard or someone goes outside of the court, then the referee would say yame to stop the competition and to restart again. 続けて始め. 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 続けて means to continue and 始め means to start. So it's basically the phrase that the referee uses to restart the match. So after yame, then there will be some kind of like 中国, 警告, and all those, which we will cover later in the video. And they will say 続けて始め with this hand sign, with the front stance. 中国, 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 中国. There are four types of warnings in karate, and if you do four times, then you're disqualified. 中国 means to warn someone. So they're letting them know that if you do this one more time, I mean, if you do it four times, then you're going to be disqualified. So it's the lowest level of warnings that you can get. Keikoku. 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 Keikoku is a stronger way of saying be careful in Japanese. So ke actually is another phrase that's used for police. So in Japanese, police are said keisatsu. So it's a stronger way to warn someone. So 中国 is the first one, and then it comes up to 警告. 反則注意. 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 反則 means disqualified, and 注意 also means to be careful. So the fourth warning is disqualified status. So it's the one that's below it. It basically means that the referee is warning you that the next time you'll be disqualified. So the phrase is 反則注意。反則反則反則反則 means disqualify, so you're out of the match. 上段蹴り上段蹴り上段蹴り上段蹴り上段 is the same meaning, and 蹴り means to kick. So you say 上段蹴り which means kick to the head, so that can be 回し蹴り、裏回し、打ち回し、蹴上げ、蹴込み、anything, any kind of kick that's related to your head. 上段突き上段突き上段突き上段突き Maybe this is a familiar phrase. 上段 means to the head or to the upper part. So in karate, that's all these parts right here. And 突き or 突き means to punch. So it's the punch to the upper part. 中段蹴り中段蹴り中段蹴り中段突き中段 means to the stomach area. So in karate, that's from here all the way to where your belt is. And including your back as well. So any kind of punch that's to the 中段 is called a 中段突き. You usually see it in a counter. 中段突き中段突き中段突き中段蹴り Like we mentioned, 中段 means stomach, 蹴り means kick. So it's a kick to the stomach. 有効有効有効有効有means there is existence of, and 効 means some kind of effect. So 有効 means that there was an effect on something, meaning that your punches or your attack landed, that it actually worked. There are three types of points in 組手. 有効 which stands for 1 point. So the later two we'll be covering, but 有効 means 1 point in 組手. 技あり技あり技あり技あり技 means technique, and ari means that there is an existence of. So 有効 stood for that there was a good effect, but 技あり is concentrating on the actual technique. So the direct translation would be that there was a good technique there. But in karate, according to the rule, 技あり stands for 2 points, and the referee does this motion. And that stands for the attack of your kick,to the 中段 so it's only 中段蹴り that's 技あり一本一本一本一本 stands for 3 points in 組手 so 有効 was 1 point 技あり 2 points 一本 was 3 points 引き分け引き分け引き分け引き分け引き分け means that it's a tie so maybe when you do a team 組手 gameThere can be a 引き分け or a tie, so the referee would do this. 選手選手選手選手選手 which meant players. This 選手 is different. 選 means first, and 手 means to take. According to this situation, you took the point first. So after, if you're the first person that took the point, then the referee would say, let's say to the blue, 青選手 with this gesture.選手取りません選手取りません選手取りません選手取りません選手 like the last one means you took first so it's giving to the person that scored first and 取れません means you cannot take so which means in the last 15 seconds if you go out of the court then there's no more point of you getting the 選手 this hand gesture would be 選手取れませんSo if you see it in a match, maybe in the Olympics in this summer, you can know that this means that there is no more 選手 on the player. 赤の勝ち赤の勝ち赤の勝ち赤の勝ち赤 means red, like we mentioned. No means of, and 勝ち means to win. So it means that the red won. あとしばらくあとしばらくあとしばらくあとしばらく。あと means the rest of or that there is a remaining of. And しばらく means just a little bit. So the main referee says あとしばらく 15 seconds before the match ends to let the players know that there's not that much time left. 危険危険危険危険き means to throw away to, or to let go. And ken means the right. So in this situationIt's for a 組手 match or a kata. You're throwing away the right to participate in that match, meaning abstention in English. So it can be before the match starts, you can do kiken, or maybe during the match, let's say you get injured, then you can tell the referee that you don't want to be you don't want to continue playing. So that's kikeng. Kikeng, ki means to throw away or to let go, and keng means the right. So in this situation, it's for a kumite match or a kata, you're throwing away the right to participate in that match, meaning abstention in English. So it can be before the match starts, you can do kiken, or maybe during the match, let's say you get injured, then you can tell the referee that you don't want to be you don't want to continue playing. So that's kiken. Jōgai. 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 Jō means the place, and gai means outside. So during a kumite match, when you go outside the court, then you might get notified that you're jōgai, which means out of the court. Shushin, shushin, shushin. Shushin means the main referee. So it's the referee that's in the middle. Fukushin, 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 fukushin. Fukushin in kumite is the four referees at the corner. So they don't have the right to stop the match, but they have the right to let the shushin, or the main referee, know that the player is scored. Kansa. 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 Kansa is the last piece of the referees. He or she is outside and let the shushin and the fukushin, main judge and the sub-referees, know if there's a mistake. Now that you've learned all the phrases and its pronunciation, I'll show it to you in order. So I'll have two players, both for kata and kumite, and you can see it with the procedures.
세레츠 正面に レイ お互いに レイ 判定、青の勝ち。 正面に、 レイ。 お互いに、 レイ。 選手。 勝負。 赤、序盤突き有効、赤、選手、次は。 青、序盤突き1本、次は。 中段突き有効、次は締め。青、中段蹴り技あり、次は締め。青、中国、次は締め。 青警告、次で始め。青反則注意、次で始め。あとしばらく。赤反則注意、選手取れません、次で始め。 青反則、赤の勝ち。
Thank you so much for watching. That was the Japanese words that the referee uses. If you would like to see more of Japanese related karate videos, I recommend these two. This one's for beginners, and this is all the Shotokan katas pronounced in Japanese. And make sure if you guys like these kind of videos, subscribe to my channel and hit the like button, and also the notification bell as well. See you tomorrow.